isolation facilities in the country must be maintained at a high state of preparedness through continuous capacity building and provisions of adequate PPEs for healthcare workers, supported by the continuous implementation of infection prevention and control measures. And 12, the county governments shall also enhance investment in piped and portable oxygen to isolation and critical care treatment facilities for the management of severe cases. And 13, the nationwide curfew is hereby extended for a further containment of 60 days, and in that regard, all bars and restaurants and other establishments open to the public must, as is current, close by 9 p.m. 14, to provide business continuity during the containment period, exemption on the application of curfew is hereby granted to essential service providers, factories working on two shifts, construction sites. All these are allowed to operate their night shifts. 15, to secure the implementation of the revised containment measures and to ensure effective enforcement of the same, today, in conjunction with my colleagues from the county governments, we have established an intergovernmental coordination framework in each of the nation's 47 counties. The county's intergovernmental committee will be co-chaired by the respective county governors and county commissioners and feature representatives of the county security teams, the county health chiefs, and the county government enforcement units. The county's intergovernmental committee shall be convened at least once every week to assess the county-specific compliance levels. 18, the Cabinet Secretary for Transport, jointly with the Cabinet Secretary for Health, are directed to develop revised protocols for public transport in consultation with all stakeholders in the transport sector.